Good evening and salutations, my B&B fans. So, Hope, you need to seriously mind your damn business, okay? You know, and I watched it yesterday, and she was in the theater saying, well, you know, you just have to have a little bit of compassion for Finn and, you know, what he's going through with Sheila. And I think, first of all, Hope, she didn't ask you to give her marital advice, okay? You just wrecked your own home, and you're sitting there telling her how to deal with her husband is a joke and an insult all in one, okay? Stuffy literally is going through pretty much PTSD, right? And you think coming to her and being like, well, you know, I was talking to Finn, you think that's something that she wants to hear? I'm like, can you actually be that clueless? Is that even possible? And so today, when she sat there talking to Thomas about the advice that she gave on Steffi, and she was all like, well, you know, she wasn't really too receptive, and I'm just like, yeah. Because honestly, tell you the truth, if you went through that, would you want somebody sitting there giving you unsolicited advice that you didn't ask for? So why the hell are you sitting there doing that to her for? I literally sat there and was like, you can't be this dumb. You seriously cannot be this dumb. On top of the fact that she's that disrespectful for making out in Eric's office again, I'm like, I know Brad Bell is kind of cheap, but Jesus Christ, y'all can't go back to his apartment and do that? You know, Thomas was not really too pleased with, Finn and his reaction towards Sheila and how he's dealing with it. Like, okay. It's his feelings, he'll deal with it how he sees fit. Now, Finn is back, talking to Steffi, and they go back to the house, and they chill for a little bit, and he takes a nap or whatever, and he has a bad dream of Steffi just, you know, killing his wife. I mean, killing his mother. Again, his bio mom. Wakes up and he's in a cold sweat. He's looking at where the blood of his bio mom used to be. I mean, it's insane. I'm like, bro, you need therapy. Okay? You need therapy. Let's just be honest, bro. I can't sit there and trust this man under the knife, and you got all this stuff going on. I can't trust your judgment as far as you trying to prescribe pills to people when your mind isn't even, it's not even there. Like, you need to sit there and take some time. So Poppy acts like a POS to her daughters, and that they're telling her, well, you just have to keep lying, because if you tell the truth, you're going to lose everything. And you don't want to do that. So the best course, the best way to sit down their relationship is to continue to lie. What the? What kind of parental advice is that? Let's be honest. I feel like part of the reason why she wants her to lie is that way Lee won't be on her ass. Because Lee has been on her ass since practically birth at this point, okay? And she doesn't want all the smoke that she's going to get from Lee, the I told you you was right and I told you I was right and everything like that. She doesn't want that. So her and Zenny's like, no, you gotta sit and keep lying. So that's what she does. And at one point when RJ comes to the room, he's about to tell her the truth, but you know, Bobby's like, oh, she just doesn't like PDA or whatever, so they leave, right? Then he's like, you know, he's working and stuff like that. He's like, hey, listen, I'm at work right now, so you need to, I don't know, find something to do. Or, like, don't you have a job or something like that? And Poppy's like, well, excuse me for being worried about my daughter. It's like, can you be worried about your daughter at, like, your own place? Because, you know, this is work right here. I can't believe she actually said that as an excuse to be, like, just hanging out there. Like, oh, I got work to do. Excuse me for sitting there worrying about my daughter. Idiot, you are part of the reason why you're worrying about your daughter. And that's number two. Number one, I gotta work. I don't know what you do for a living, but right now this is what I do. So why don't you sit there and take you and your special meds and take your ass on out this damn office, because to be honest, you really don't have a reason for being here. Because your dog's not even in his room right now. And, you know, he starts, you know, one of the things he does is then say, well, you know, if Roger drops the ball, you know, I'm going to beat it. You know, I mean, I didn't want it to happen the way it happened, but I'm just saying, like, you know, if he drops the ball, you know, I'm going to be there to pick up that rebound, you know, that's just, you know. Yeah, I feel like that's actually, I feel like that's about it, and it's probably just because, you know, again, I watched yesterday's episode. I couldn't do the live stream because I just felt like it was going to be better to do it on Saturday. I mean, tonight, I'm going to wind up doing the live stream, so if you are a B&B fan, I'm going to be talking about that as well. But I was like, you know what, I'll just move the regular live stream to Saturday because I know I would have time to be there. And I feel rushed because of today. I had to work super early in the morning. And I'm the type of person that when I do something, I want to do it 100%. I want to do it 100%. I want to be there in the moment. I want to give 100% to everyone decides, you know, for everyone who comes to the live stream tonight. Because I do talk about all the shows. I may not always review everything, but I do watch them. The gate's coming out, maybe 5 soap operas, hoping that B&B does not drop the ball. I've been enjoying it so far. I know some people have not been liking it or whatever, but I've been enjoying it so far. I got a question I'm going to sit there and ask. Let's just say, for the sake of argument, B&B was like, I don't really know about this TV thing anymore, but I heard Days is doing pretty well on Peacock, so we got a little Paramount thing going on. Maybe we should do that. My question is, would you actually watch B&B on a streaming service? They suddenly pulled the Days, and just be very clear, Days didn't have a choice. Okay? If not go on Peacock, it was not going to be on in general, okay? That was literally the Hail Mary. It was like they had to jump because everything else around them was just falling down. So it sounded very funny, like, well, maybe Dennis could sit there and go back to NBC and, like, what's wrong with you? Like, what's wrong with you? But, you know, again, if B&B... So I have to go to Peacock, would you sit there and watch? Would you pay the $4.99 or $5.99, whatever it will be? I don't even remember how much I actually paid for Peacock at this point. I mean, for Peacock also, but for also Paramount, though. But I do actually like Paramount. There's stuff that I do want to sit there and watch, like the new Knuckles series. And I finally got a chance to watch Mission Impossible, so I'm very... The last one, so I'm very happy about that. Even though I was not exactly thrilled with the direction that it went in, I'll say that much, but also from the beginning, when I was in high school, or junior high school, so, you know, at this point, why not? Anyway, like I said, I feel like that's about it, but I also feel, as always, I'm missing something. I'm going to be watching YNR next. I may not actually have time to do a review, but I'm going to be watching As Boss too. If you are a YNR fan, we're going to be talking about that as well. Come through tonight, 8 p.m. Eastern, 5 p.m. Pacific, and we'll chop it up. And again, as if everything, the stars line, hopefully I want to sit there and try to do it at 12. My line is true. New York time, I'll find a central and everything else. Put that out because I'm going to be talking about B&B and YNR also. So come through. Anyway, with that being said, I'm going to go. I'll see you in the next video.